if the comparison test works, it works quite easy and really fast, as you will see in the examples in this video. Suppose we have the series 1 to infinity of an, where an equals 5 over 20 squared plus 4n plus 3, and we want to know whether it converges or not. Well, in this case, you could do the integral test, by the way. It's quite a lot of work. Comparison test works much faster, as we will see. We know that 2n squared plus 4n plus 3 is bigger than 2n squared, because n is positive, so this 4n plus 3 is positive, so that's why 2n squared plus 4n plus 3 is bigger than 2n squared. So if you do 1 over those, the inequality sign flips, so we know that 1 over 2n squared plus 4n plus 3 is in fact smaller than 1 over 2n squared. So we have that our an are smaller than 5 times it's 2 over n squared, which we will call our bn. Now take a look at our bn. Sum n to infinity of bn equals sum n 1 to infinity 5 over 2n squared. You can take the 5 over 2 to the front. And we are left with the sum n equals 1 to infinity of the 1 over n squared. But we recognize that series. It is a p series with p equals 2, bigger than 1. And if your p in your p series is bigger than 1, you know your series converges. So the sum n from 1 to infinity of 1 over n squared converges. And 5 over 2 converges, well, of course, to a number which is 5 over 2 times higher, but still convergent. So we know our series of the bn converges. We know that all our an are positive. We have a bn series which is above our series with the an, which means that our series with the an also converges due to the comparison test. Next example, sum from k equals 1 to infinity ak, where ak equals the ln of k over k. And this is slightly annoying, because we want to estimate the ln of k. So what we do, we say, well, my sum k equals 1 to infinity of ak equals a1 plus a2, and then I start at 3, k equals 3 to infinity ak. Well, if you plug in 1, you get ln 1 over 1 equals 0, and if you plug in 2, you get ln 2 over 2. So let's say only the a2 is left over here, and our sum from 3 to infinity. Now we can estimate this new sum, because if k is bigger or equal than 3, I know that the log, the natural log of k, is bigger than 1. The ln of the Euler number e equals 1, and then the function increases. 3 is bigger than the Euler number, so that's why the ln of k is bigger than 1. Then we know the ln of k over k is bigger than 1 over k, and we will use that as our bk. Now I know that the sum k from 3 to infinity of the bk is divergent. It's the harmonic series, or a p series with p equals 1, which is less or equal than 1. So I know that the sum 3 to infinity of the bk is divergent. So we can use now our comparison test. Our ak are even bigger than our bk. That's what we showed over here. So the sum of the ak is even bigger than this divergent series. So the sum starting at 3 to infinity is divergent. So if I add a few terms, that series is of course divergent as well. So my series lnk over k from 1 to infinity is a divergent series.